$1.6 trillion. That's the total of student loan debt in this country. And those loans follow borrowers well beyond graduation day. The policy journal Education Next reports 37% of U.S. adults ages 18 to 29 carry student loan debt, as do 22% of adults aged 30 to 44. Christian Barnard, education policy analyst at the Reason Foundation, joins me now to take a look at this. Christian, thanks for being with us today.
Thanks for having me on.
So we've got some senators, we got some presidential candidates talking about student loan forgiveness, including Bernie Sanders. He wants to forgive all student loan debt. What do you make of that?
Well, I think it's bad policy to basically give out a massive entitlement only on the basis of how much debt somebody has, student loan debt in this case, because a lot of the debt is held by people who have higher level degrees. A lot of the borrowing was done by students who were going to elite schools. So if you want to manage the problem of expensive colleges, I think you need to get to the root of the issue. Student loan forgiveness is basically not tackling the root of the issue, and it's in a way rewarding poor financial decision making.
Is the root of the issue here the increased cost? I mean, I think it was William Bennett, former Secretary of Education. He said when you offer more and more scholarships and grant programs, then colleges start charging more money. Is that the root cause?
That's right. So there's a lot of evidence that the kind of saturated, artificial saturation in federal aid that has actually been captured. So as you've increased aid to these colleges, they've been able to capture a lot of that, sometimes up to 65 cents for every additional federal dollar that's offered. So that's part of the problem. But yeah, the institutions themselves, tuition has more than doubled since the 80s. I think the problem is they don't really have any skin in the game, so they can keep charging more and more. And what's happening is there's starting to be a bigger disconnect between what the labor market can bear, right, and what these colleges are charging. So the return on investment is plummeting. So I want to see colleges be held responsible by alternative financing methods that actually make it so that they want to invest in the programs that benefit their kids, their students, and their alumni, and maybe pull away from administrative bloat or the other things that are driving costs up and not actually benefiting kids down the line.
So let's talk about some of those alternatives. I know one of the proposals you propose is from Purdue University, right? Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so these are income sharing agreements. So what this does is, like I was mentioning before, realign the incentives in that way. So rather than traditional student loans, a group of private investors or the college itself will basically foot the bill for a student's education. And based on their major and the university that they're at, what they'll do is pay a fixed portion of their future income over the next 10, 15 years. So as their income goes up, the payment goes up, right? So what this does is makes it so investors are going to invest in the programs that they have a reasonable expectation will pay for those kids down the line. That way, these universities actually have skin in the game. It's very different from the really cheap credit federal loan and federal aid market that you have now for students, which has been a big part of the problem for why we are where we're at now.
So that's one of the alternatives, is this proposal where private investors invest in the program and helps these children, these young people. But I want to talk about the, you know, poor people that might be helped with the student loan forgiveness. I mean, people having struggles, they have hundreds of thousands of dollars in debts if they went to medical school, law school, their spouse as well. They can't get a house. They can't. So shouldn't, why shouldn't the government get involved in saying, okay, we're going to wipe out your debt?
Well, so wiping out the debt is such poor targeting for those kinds of students. I think there's definitely a conversation that can be had about income-based repayments, right? This is a very widely available option for students whose college education is not paying dividends for them now. So it's kind of similar, it readjusts their repayment plans to look like an income sharing agreement that I was just discussing. But yeah, there's certainly a conversation to be had about targeting the kids who have maybe gone to schools and have a lot of debt, who were poor, who might not have had all the information at their disposal to make wise decisions. But eliminating all student loan debt only a small sliver of that kind of entitlement program would actually help those students. So we can have a conversation about helping the poor students, but you don't need to include basically this giant welfare program for the rich to do that.
But you win some votes by saying to millennials,
exactly,
I'm going to forgive your loan. So we'll see what happens. Thank you so much, Christian Barnard, education policy analyst. Thank you so much for your time today. We appreciate it very much.